Alright guys, welcome to another ILLUMAESTHETIC tutorial. My name's Adam, and we're going to explain to you how to install the Mitsubishi Lancet Evo 10 gauge cluster. This will be for both versions of the Evo 10 gauge cluster. This is for the smaller red LCD screen, which is what you see here, the earlier generation, as well as what we call the color LCD screen, which is this one. You'll notice on the color version, there's a lot of black infill around the LCD screen, whereas on the non-color version, you're going to see it's very open. Mind you, this is an aftermarket gauge face that we have here, so don't be alarmed if this doesn't look like it yet. What do you need as far as materials? You're going to need needle nose pliers, serrated and also thin. If you've seen our other tutorials, you'll notice that this is a very useful tool. A glue of some sort. We're using butyl tape. You can use hot glue. We generally do not recommend using super glue because it frosts. And of course, you're going to need your aftermarket gauge faces, which is made by ILLUMAESTHETIC. You're gonna notice that we have two different styles. If you have the red version gauge, LCD gauge face, or cluster, you're gonna notice that your gauge face is one large piece. If you have the color version, you're gonna notice that it's three pieces. Do not mix this up. They do not interchange. So make sure you buy the right one. And if you have any questions, email us. So now that we have that covered, we'll go right into the install. First thing you're gonna do, you're going to uninstall the bezel, which is just these clips. And this is the same for both clusters, and I'll make adjustments if anything is different between the two. Now that we have it off, we have both versions, and you can see very clearly how it works as far as the one piece and the three piece. First, we're going to start with the one piece gauge face because it is a lot easier. You're going to notice two very distinct things. You're going to notice that the Evo 10 gauge face for the red LCD, they both have stops, so I cannot push them past the zero point without adding significant force. However, you're going to notice that the Evo 10 color version, the motors are magnetic, so they're going to snap to certain positions like this. Whereas this is kind of free to move wherever it wants. So you see, I can just kind of do this. It's hard to describe on camera, but you'll know what I feel when I feel it. So you see this? You see how it's kind of magnetic? This one does not do that. Okay. This makes uninstalling the Evo 10 one-piece case a lot easier. So what you're gonna do, if you own this gauge case, very, very simple. You're just gonna go ahead and rotate and pry up like that. You may need to use a little more force than what I showed pictured because I've already done this one, but it's generally very easy. So do not be afraid to use a little bit of force because these shafts do not come out. At least not without significant amount of pressure. So you're just gonna twist and pull up. If you wanna use a pry tool, you can. We don't recommend it just because it's a little forceful and you may damage the soft faces if you care. Now that it's out, simply pull it up and out. Take your new gauge face, put it in. We have these little guide holes like OEM. Flip it in, like so. So make sure that sits under. And if you do have a white gauge face, use gloves. You're going to put the needles in. If you do have a white gauge face, and this is just kind of off topic, you may want to actually paint these needles red, just as a stylistic thing. You can actually get red needles straight off Maillard gauges if you want to do that. Or you can look at, you know, generalized tutorials, and you'll see that it's paint on the bottom of the needle. So what you're going to do is you're going to scrape this paint off or send it off or remove it. And basically just take some nail polish and, you know, do the same stuff. You know, also light up it. It's not something that we do, but there's a lot of information on how to do that also. So if that's something you want to do, there's a great mod. And we may do a video on it later, but not today. So now you're going to put the needle back in. And you're just going to rotate till you feel that spot, right? And you're going to get that spot straight down into the unit. Just like that. Same thing with mosquito. Great now. And that's basically it. You're done. Put the bezel back on and just go back in the car. Super straightforward. If you guys have the red LCD version, your life is super easy. Okay, so now we're done with this one. We're gonna move on to the color version. So the color version's a bit more difficult. If you've seen the GVGR Subaru or the VA Subaru, you essentially have the exact same motors on this cluster. So one of two things can happen. either you get lucky and this needle separates from the metal shaft without too much effort, or you get unlucky and this metal shaft right here starts coming up and out of the motor. So how do you know what is what? What you're going to do first is you're going to take that, your finger, and just rotate it. If you hear a lot of noise like that, most likely that shaft is going to come out. Don't freak out. Just make sure you watch the tutorial before you do it yourself. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do this one. And it's generally the same thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly twist and pull, but I want to keep a visual eye on the metal shaft coming up and down. So in this case, I got lucky and the pin did not come out. This is what happens if you get lucky. If you get lucky, your life is a lot easier, right? And then in this case, the case will come straight out. And you don't need to do anything. However, there are times where you do get unlucky. We've had to simulate it because this gauge happens to be a good gauge. And we've actually gone to make sure that the needle comes up. There's no gauge face here, but it should give you a visualization. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to twist this up. I'm going to slowly pull up. And don't try to yank it out because you do not want this to all of a sudden come up, which is why we're twisting. Okay, and then you're gonna keep going up and you're gonna notice that compared to a shaft that doesn't come out, you're gonna notice a lot more side to side play. So this does not have a lot of play, but if I keep on playing this up, you're gonna notice that a lot of play, and it's gonna wiggle out a lot more. So I'm gonna continue to really keep it up. Okay, and at a certain point, you're gonna be able to see that metal shaft through the gauge face. So I'm gonna keep pulling up a little more. Okay, and what you're gonna do, you're gonna grab your pliers, and you're basically going to shove them in here until you can grab the physical metal shaft. And this is all without pulling out that metal. If you need to pull it up slightly more, you should have room to do so. Okay, so metal shaft. Grab right here. You're gonna grab pretty hard, but make sure you don't bend the shaft. Okay, and then you're gonna break the needle free from the shaft. And what you can do is you can just jimmy it, wiggle it, until it comes up and out completely. Make sure that the pliers actually can hold the shaft and the shaft's not just spinning in the plug. Okay. And you're going to hear noises when you feel the needle finally separate from the shaft. Now once this is out, as long as it's not completely out, go ahead and immediately push it back in. Okay. Repeat the process with this side is what we already know is good. And what you're going to notice is if you do have one good shaft and one bad shaft, you're going to notice that the bad shaft has a lot more up and down play. So let's see if I can do audio. But you can notice that there's a lot more play on that one than there is. So what we need to do is we need to actually physically reset the slack on these motors. Because what you're going to notice is if you don't,
these needles get stuck, right? They don't, they get a little caught up in it, which is not ideal. Whereas, you see this one, it doesn't get stuck anywhere. This thing's clearly, so this is how we know this is not going to have stuck. Okay. So how we do that is we're going to go ahead and pull this backing off the cluster. And you might need to use a flathead for this because it is, for the Evo 10, it is a little annoying. But too. And you're going to pull this off the front face. You're going to go ahead and pry this off. So you're going to notice that there is metal rivets holding this in. So you can go ahead and take your pry bar or whatever you want to use, pry this off. They've already been broken. And then you're going to take your LED pin that we include with the kits. And you're going to locate this black pin right here. This pin will help reset the slack on the motor. Right? So what you're going to do, you're going to take the pin. Put the one pin up into the hole. And you're going to notice you can actually play around with the pin even with the LED. Okay. So what you're essentially going to do is you're going to put this against a solid surface and then push this pin in. So do that right now, so just kind of rotate it. Like that. So forward. Now you're going to feel the motor with the pliers. If it has a very little bit of play, having play is okay when you want to have play. But if you push it in too far, there's no play at all. Right, so let's just show you another figure, for example. This is a good butter. This is the one we're trying to fix. Right, freely spin, no problem. We pushed this magnet a little too far, so it's fine. See that? We don't want that. So how do we fix it? So what you're going to do is you're going to grab your needle nose pliers, put them to the very bottom, right here. Push this needle all the way down. Right, and then you're going to do the same thing you did to get it out. You're going to tug slightly while rotating up until you get that play. Okay. Make sure that it really spins and it doesn't get snagged on anything. Right. Now you're going to grab the pliers, hold it, and again, separate the needle. So this is reset, we're good there. So we can reassemble. The hard part is now done. I'm gonna take my hot glue or my butyl tape, place them on the three corners, the metal cover, put this metal cover back on. I'm gonna put this back in. Okay. I'm gonna put this cover back on. And now, we should be at the same point if you got unlucky versus if you did get lucky. If you get lucky, you should be at this point where the faces are removed and the needles are off, and if you got unlucky, you've reset the motor, and now you're ready to put everything back together. Where do we go from here? Now you're gonna take your super duper awesome ILLUMAESTHETIC gauge faces, available on illumaesthetic.com, and install them. So, you're gonna have these two little clips here, like OEM. I'm gonna slide it in like that. Just goes into the hole, everything should line up like OEM. And then with this one, again, goes into the hole. Same thing with this one. Slide it in the middle. Slide it in the middle. Wipe it down if you need to, or use gloves. Now we're gonna put the needles back on. It's worth noting, like last time, if you want to change the color of your gauges, or sorry, your needles, you're going to scrape all this paint off and just nail polish it whatever color you want. There are plenty of other tutorials online. You can find them. Go ahead and do your own.
So, do not put these in all the way in, just put them on the very top just so you can calibrate it correctly before you start messing with it, right? So, these needles, like the red LCD gauge, point straight down. Like this, right? So you're gonna notice. And if you need to readjust it, you can go ahead and just spin them all over again. And at any point, if you do install this and decide you don't like the calibration, you can always take the bezel off and recalibrate it this way. You do not need to take the bezels off to recalibrate. So now, once we're good and we're happy with where it is, the bezel can go back in. Well, actually, before I do that, plug this into your car and make sure it works first. Then put the bezel back in. So once the bezel is back in, you're ready to install this and you're ready to get ready to rock. Let's cut to some finished pictures. But that more or less concludes the how to install your Evo 10 gauge clusters, both red LCD and color LCD version. Thank you for watching this video. Take care and make sure to check out illumaesthetic.com to get your gauge faces for these clusters. Thank you.